there. Thank you for deciding to tune in to another edition of the Vapor's Den. My name is Aaron. I'll be your host for a while. Today, I thought I would take a little step off the regular beaten path here inside the Vapor's Den. In light of certain previous little videos as of recent in regards to like California state law and the lingering dark cloud and stuff, I just kind of wanted to shake that all off today, try to put that behind us. And today, I thought you could do a product review. Nah. You could talk another PSA for, you know, public service announcement for vape health and vape safety. Nah. I haven't researched the material, wouldn't know what I'm talking about. And I thought to myself, let's step off the beaten path today and not be so concerned with product reviews and PSAs and talking about law. Why don't we just do a good old-fashioned build, an RDA build? So this is a tutorial on how to build, or at least the way I build, an RDA. Now, mind you, my ways might not necessarily be your ways, and that's quite all right. I mean, different strokes for different folks, you know? Differences make the world go round. So what I do today inside this video, again, might not necessarily be the way you do it, or have done it, or will attempt to do it maybe for the first time, and you're tuning in to hear, and you're going to allow me to assist and help guide you on a proper RDA build. And today, our guinea pig to build upon is one of my biggest RDAs I have in my vape gear arsenal. I got three 26650 RDAs. And I thought I'd build on the easiest one here today. We are building on the Buddha V1 26650 RDA 30mm powerhouse. Full-size portholes, full-size screws, side air induction on the opposing posts, 510 copper pin, adjustable plastic airflow rotator, hardened plastic chuff cap. Just one awesome easy RDA to build upon. So I kind of wanted the biggest to be caught on camera. And so what we're going to do is a process that I haven't done in a very long time. We're going to do a process and we're going to go desk level. I'm going to take you and the camera and we're going to be whisked away to my desktop. And I'm going to give you a small little, as quick as I can, laundry list on what you're going to need to build an RDA, or at least the tools that I use to build an RDA. Again, you're different, you might do it differently, and that's quite all right. But your grocery list and my grocery list, I guarantee you, is about 80 to 85% close to being the same. So on that note, no real product review here, no PSAs, no dark clouds of putting out law. We're just going to have some fun and build up an RDA and see what happens. And also, disclaimer and pre-apology, my previous tutorials have run a little lengthy in time, and if time management is a very important thing to you, you might want to whisk yourself away here on YouTube and go to a person called Rip Tripper. He's got some RDA builds in his video library. He'll help you build at frickin' warp speed with high theatrical production value. You never know, you catch it on fire and go, woo! Or if you want a little bit more timely, but we'll get you there, you could stroll yourself on here on YouTube and look for a guy named Grim Green. He's done some RDA builds, and he will take you a little bit slower than Rip Tripper, and he will slow jam the news with you. But me, I'm not quite that, you know, I'm going to take my time with you, because we want to do this right, don't we? I mean, yeah, we could blast through it at warp speed, high theatrical production value, slow jam the news, whatever. But we're going to do it right. So we're going to go desk level. We're just going to have some fun. However long it takes, however long it takes. See you, desk level. Here we go. Hello there, and welcome aboard Desk Level again. Haven't done this in quite some time. I'll try to speed you through this grocery list so that we can get right to the build and get the vaping on it and see how things go. I guarantee you, as I said when I was sitting in my chair, that your grocery list and mine are probably 80 to 85 to 90% the same if we are going to attempt RDA builds. And now to dive right into it, for me, I take out from a micro screwdriver set just your standard flathead right there. I take out a larger flathead to do the screws when I'm doing the positioning. I only use the smaller flathead to do cotton positioning. And then actually what I'll use to spool the wire around the micro screwdriver, I use a sunburst style T10 size screwdriver, micro screwdriver. My Buddha V1, my Temple, and my Remus love the T10 size as far as the Kenthal wrap. So I'm just going to keep the Buddha liking what it likes today and just keep it the same. Of course, you're going to need your RDA. That's mine right there. Pair of scissors to cut your cotton. Pair of tweezers to possibly pull your cotton through the coil once it's properly built. You're going to need a pair of build wire cutters, little snips here, and or if you don't have this, and if you're going to build 22 to 20 gauge, I would recommend that if you don't have this or a micro plier that has a wire snip on it, I recommend toenail style toenail clippers. You know, your regular pharmacy toenail clippers. Those will work, but they have to be the toenail style. The regular finger nail style won't work. And again, to not consume so much of time, I've already pre-cut two 20 gauge Kenthal A1 wires right there, properly cut. You're going to need a needle nose pliers right there, just a basic little set. You can, if you don't have it, it's quite all right. And if all you have is cotton balls, that's quite all right. You can build your wicks with organic cotton balls every day of the week, 5 weeks come Sunday. Nothing wrong with it. I do want to warn you that if you're going to like go to your medicine cabinet right now or your pantry closet, wherever you are storing them, make sure that your cotton balls do not say hypoallergenic on them. I have two vape cotton PSA vape health and vape safety videos on file in my Vaporosity playlist if you so choose and are curious to go watch. I had a bad medical reaction, very bad overnight, required medication, milk time, and a nurse's after-hour hotline to get me through with hypoallergenic cotton balls when I first busted into the build scene. I don't want you to have that same reaction, so you can watch my video, find out what not to do, but as for the purposes of this video, I'll circumvent that, I'll circumvent your time. Don't build hypoallergenic American organic or Japanese organic or organic cotton balls could be found at Walgreens. This came with my Limo V1 organic cotton balls. So you can build with those, but I prefer, and if you have this, it's a bonus, regular Japanese organic cotton pads. Easiest to build with, pretty much industry standard nowadays. So that's it. So here I am. I'm going to clear and provide myself a little workspace right now. I have an ohms meter. It's busted. I only use it as a foundation to support my RDA in the early stages of the build. Okay. Right there. There's your quad posts right there. Almost regular sized screws. Big post holes. Side air induction. It's a great little RDA. I'm very lucky to have it. Nice person out there through social media vaped forward it to me over a year ago. Been in love with it ever since. Build on it whenever I can. So, I'm going to take my T100 right there. T100. Or you can use any size, but I prefer if you're going to do a 26650 RDA, if you only have sunburst styled micro screwdrivers, which I have more, but this one seems to be its favorite, you can build with that size. It's all what you like. Don't think vaping is so scientific that there's like a secret formula or a grocery list that you have to abide to, that you have to live by. No, it's all suggestive. That's one nice, wonderful thing about vaping and this technology. You can have it your way, any way, however you want it, every day of the week. That's one nice thing about this industry. Pardon the cloud, I'm getting a little vape in. And that's also important too. If nicotine is like where it's at for you and you're jonesing for it and you have to do a build to get it, you might want to purchase yourself, or if you don't have one already, which would be a bonus, a second mod, have it built, all that. But here we go. We're going to get to the build now. I take the non-L-shape. I always L-shape it, one end. Brace it down. You want at least an inch for your thumb to hold on to that wire. Especially with 20 gauge, it can get a little tricky. So here we go. I'm going to do a lead in, plus one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I'm just going to do a 20 gauge Kenthal A1 T10 screwdriver, 10 wrap, single strand, and then once it's built up like that, as you can see right there, if my camera can focus in on that, there we are, just leave it on the screwdriver, pull the leg leads out nice and taut right there, you want it nice and taut, and then what I do is I straighten out what was once being pinched between thumb and screwdriver. I pull that out so that the leads right there are going in the same direction. And for handling purposes, I'll make this more manageable and just do a simple little cut right there so that both leg leads are basically the same length. I will take my micro plier right there, pull one leg for about 5 seconds out, take the other one right there, pull that one out for about 5 seconds, and there we go. And then what I do, granted, you can do this during the heat pinch process once it's properly mounted and you're test firing it, but I will take my micro plier right there, I will put it on the shaft of the screwdriver, bring it down and pinch it, and it's struggling a little bit because again we're dealing with a pretty serious wire here. 20 gauge is nothing to sneeze at. It's a pretty taut, tight wire, you know, very springy, and if you don't hold it here, this screwdriver could go kaboing, you know, off to the side and get launched. And how would I know that? I'm man enough to admit my limitations and be honest with you, I've done it. That was quite entertaining, seeing a micro screwdriver going wing, flying off there. It's like, whoa. Have another vape. Vaping on my IPv4 here with the Patriot V1 here. Going a little old school today. So that's about it. I hold that for about 10-15 seconds, and now you take your RDA here, your base, and then it would help. And no, I'm not going to pause this video. I'm going to show people that, you know, I'm just a regular human being. I don't always, you know, set up these videos proper. I didn't open up these holes here to receive wire because I cleaned this before I did this video. I had this sitting for like 20 minutes in very hot water with soap in it, and use the hair dryer to force dry it for, you know, the purposes of this video, get it real nice and clean for both me and you. So now I will take one of the leads, put it in this opposing one, and take one of the leads and put it in this furthest one, dead center. And then what I do is I will take right here and stop right at the lip. This part closest to my fingernail, to the lip of the RDA reservoir right here, I will stop it right there and start to tighten down. And that's where, you know, big flathead comes into play right here. I will take that and I will just start screwing it down. Not wrenching it right now. We don't need any wrenching. Just enough to hold it firmly in place. And I will take this side as well. Screw it on down. Don't need to gut wrench it. Just enough for it to be firmly in place. And then what I do is I leave these leads on right now. Yeah, I could take my wire snips and go snip snip and make it look all pretty, but it's not time for that, at least not for me, not the way I do it. Then I will take my T10 Sunburst, slowly, gently pull out there, and now we have a mounted coil. But yes, it's not quite in the right position yet, but that's okay. Why I keep it in that position will be evident here after the next coil is made. And that's what we're going to get to do right now. I put an L in one end for just in case my hand slips down the wire. I have an anchor to grab onto so that the coil build isn't a complete bust. Because sometimes if you get a little jammed up during a coil build, sometimes that's sayonara for the coil. You got to start over again. I don't like doing that. So here we go. About an inch of wire between thumb and handle. Do a lead in. Plus one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8, 9, 10. Get the legs out straight. Legs out straight. Then make it more manageable again by cutting some of the excess off, making it more easy to handle, more easy to work with. And be very careful too, especially working with 22 and 20 gauge, sometimes 24 gauge. Make sure that when you're doing the cuts, make sure it isn't pointed towards your face. Because when these launch off, they can be like little javelins, little spears. Okay? We don't want that. That's no bueno. So I will pull taut on these again, the leads. I will pull them for about 5 seconds outward in the opposing direction. Grab that one, opposing direction. Get it all lined up proper here, and then take my screwdriver again and put it right down on the shaft of the screwdriver. And ta-da! Oh, I see a little gun astray right here, and that's all right. That's okay. And that's one nice thing here, you know. Before you really get it to the final stages, it is workable. You can do little problem-solve workarounds. That's one nice about having it on the screwdriver. It's not a finished product yet. So now I'll put a death pinch on that. Pinch it right here between handle and micro plier right there. Again, holding that for about 10, 15, 20 seconds with good downward pressure. And all this does is make the coil a little bit more easy to work with when you're trying to mount it onto the base of an RDA. That's the plain and simple of it. Also, again, the importance of possibly having a second mod available to you while you're doing a build. Because if you're nicotine dependent like I am and you're getting it through vape, you want it now.
No.
Alrighty, I think we're done with our little death pinch here. Here we go. Now again, I turn it around, put one end in the opposing, one end right there. I'm going to aim you a little down. There we go. You're in. I will take the lead that now is about ready to mash into the other coil, and I will guide that down so that it goes under, and that's why I keep that at an angle, because if I was to level that coil off right now, make it nice and straight, this lead would mash right into there and have nowhere to go. And so what I do is, again, I take it to where the end of the coil is perpendicular, hovering straight over the outer extreme lip of the RDA reservoir right there, and now I will go and tighten it down. Again, you don't need to wrench it right now. This is just positioning. This is just to get it into a position to where you can take the wire snips and make it a little bit more easier to deal with here. And take your time. You don't want to rush this, because if you do and you're not concentrating, I'm just going to do this, I'm not going to try to do this to myself, you could actually slip your screwdriver off there. It could hit your thumb, and depending upon the size of screwdriver you have, Phillips, flathead, sunburst, starburst, you could prick yourself pretty good and have a little bloody situation. So take your time. We don't need any blood. Give new definition to the term blood, sweat, and tears. Okay, now that that is preliminarily in place, at least for the moment, I will take this T10 and start sliding it out gently. And there we go. We have two coils preliminarily on the RDA base. Now I take the whole thing. This I actually use, granted, it's not an ohms meter, it's busted, but I will use it as a handle right there. Just a nice grip handle. I will take and start cinching those screws down a little bit, making them a little bit more tight. Number three, right there, and the last one. Okay. Now, for easy to work with purposes, we will now prune the wires away from the posts, the excess that's not needed, and I will turn that one up. And the one reason why it's very important not to go for positioning, because now I have room between post and coil to take my wire snips and go down there and cut off this lead right here that belongs to this coil right there. You have room. Don't be so concerned with final positioning of your coil in the preliminary stages of mounting it to an RDA. Don't be so quick to prune and trim and make it look all nice while you're doing it at the same time. That's not necessary. Leave plenty of room for your coils. Granted, they look a little weird right now, but we'll work on that. Keep the leads on there preliminarily. You don't need to worry about pruning and snipping, okay? But after it's preliminarily mounted, and then you take your ohms meter, which you could use as a handle like I do, because this is very easy now versus holding an RDA or trying to balance it or working on top of a mod with it. This way it's a little bit more safer. So on that, I'm going to take my wire sniffs, and again, toenail clippers will work if you're doing 22 and 20 gauge. Regular fingernail clippers will work if you're working with, say, 28 gauge, 26 gauge, 24 gauge, 30 gauge, 32 gauge, all that. So I will take this. Ta-da! There's one. Two. And now I will take this. It's going to be a little awkward, but we'll do it. I will take this and actually position that. See, I have plenty of room now to cut that lead right there. There it goes. And now we have one more. And again, it's very nice in the preliminary stages of an RDA, making sure you have proper room to roam and room to work. So again, having plenty of distance between coil, post, I can properly snip, and there we go. That is a proper pruned and trimmed RDA base. No more leads. Now we're just dealing with legs and coil. So now I will take my T10 again. I will slowly, in a screwing position, put it in there. And now I'm going to level the coil like so. Now it's level. It's no longer in that position, like a 45 degree angle. It is now level. I will level that, and now with the bottom, with this top part of the screwdriver, I use it as kind of a ramrod kind of a thing. Boom, boom, boom. And what I will do is I will now go for positioning. Whittling it, whittling it, whittling it, and going for positioning. Like so. And then I will take the other coil, take my T10, screw, just gently, because you don't want to, you know, upset the coil. Lift up. Now that's level, pretty much, right there. So that's in a regular level position. And then I will take again the base of the handle and put it right on in there, and boom, 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 boom. Go for a little positioning right there. Okay, that one is looking good. Looking good. Almost right where I want it to be. This coil is moving and grooving a little bit more better than this one. And you might come across that from time to time, that one side will play more nice with you than the other. So that one is awesome positioning. Awesome positioning. This coil, that one's being awesome. Right there. Let's see if I can zoom that in here a little bit better for you. There we go. Yeah. This one's being real good for positioning. I like that. Now we got to work on this one a little bit. Let this one know who's boss. But sometimes they think they're the boss. Okay. Okay, that one's almost right where I need it to be. Okay, And also remember, this process we're doing right here is not the final process to make your coils look handsome and or pretty. This is just positioning so they're as even inside perpendicular to the center posts as you can get them. But this isn't the end. Just because that doesn't mean we can vape. No. This just puts them in a position. And now, I'm going to double check my screws. Just a quick little check right there. Right there. Because when you do move a wire around, it can jimmy the screw a little bit, and they can come a little loose. So it's always important periodically to just double check and make sure things are, you know, tight as they should be. That one's good. I just do a little double check here, and that one is good. And now, these are uneven. Yeah, this coil's a little bit higher. So now I go for elevation. I have good placement, but this one needs to come down. So you just take it, at least for me, and I grab on both sides, and I just give a little tiny bit of rocking, slightly rocking downward pressure. And that just put it at the same elevation, the same height as the other coil, which is good. Okay, now we're going to need a device. And for the purposes of this video, I am bringing in the Fuchai 200 watt. And you need something like this, especially if you're building with 22, 20 gauge, especially 20 gauge and above wire. You're going to need a proper power delivery system, such as the Fuchai 200, Sigelli 213, Sigelli 150 TC, stuff like that. Okay, it's nice and tight on there. Turn that on. Full battery. And we're going to do a preliminary. I don't know if you can see this, but right now we are at 0.19 ohms. We are subbing, not a problem. Now, due to the fact that I've done my preliminary read and we're at 0.19, which is good, I take my micro plier right here, needle nose, little arced angle right there. And then what I do is I'm going to do a process called heat and pinch, heat and pinch, heat and pinch until the coil is real nice and tight. And after the heat and pinch, we might have to do a process called strum, strum, strum. So here we go. We're going to deal with this boy first, right on over here. Here we go. Little smoke's going to come off. Oh, we got to do a strum strum right from the beginning. We're getting like a hot area. Just take a flathead screwdriver, strum it right on the coil, just as if you were strumming guitar strings on a guitar. Just nice little strum strum strum. And I'm also going to do the other one just for redundancy purposes. And we'll check and see. Okay, gonna need a little bit more right there, gonna need a little bit more right here. That's almost perfect now. Alright, bangy bangy. That's almost perfect. A little strum, 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 and just take your time. As you can see, I'm taking my time and we're getting it right. Very nice glow now. You want it heating up from the center of the coil and expanding outward. You don't want it heating up on the outer fringes and heating inward. Always want that inward glow going out. Never vice versa. Just do a couple more little preliminary strums. And look at that. Very, very nice. Now, I could leave it at that, and we are now at 0.2 ohms. So it jumped up by 0.01%, which is fine. I love vaping around 0.2, 0.3. That's home for me. So now I will take my micro plier, my little needle nose, and now I'm going to a process called heat and pinch. Heat it up. Nice. Let off the trigger. Grab, ever so slightly, pinch, and hold for about 10 seconds, doing your best not to move. What this is doing is a minor forging of the coil itself. You've heated it up to a point where it's malleable, it's workable. You grab your micro plier, you do a squeeze, very so slightly, just to make sure all the wraps now are snug against each other as best you can. And you let go. That is a beautiful looking coil. Now we're going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to do the other one. While doing this, if you don't have the silicone coated micro plier or pincher or crimper, if yours aren't silicone coated on top, that means you can't touch your coil while it's being heated up with your fingers on the trigger. You got to ease off the trigger with non-silicon coated and then pinch as the coil is doing a cool down without the trigger being used. You could short out your coil if you don't do it that way, but if you have the silicon tips, all bets are off. You can fire it and pinch it all at the same time, which is a more efficient way of doing it. So here we go. I'm hitting the trigger. Getting that one nice and red. Off trigger. Grab. Pinch ever so slightly. Just a gentle, gentle pinch. You don't have to gut wrench this. You don't have to go balls to the wall with it. No, no, no. Just a nice little pinch, gentle. Hold for about, again, 10, 15, 20 seconds, allowing cool down. And literally, this is just a micro forging process. You've heated the metal to the point that it can be malleable and workable. You've pinched, you've gotten the wraps close together, and then you let off, and room temperature alone should cool it down proper. And what do you know? Not bad looking. Not bad. And now, to finish this off, we're not quite done yet. To do this proper, you're going to have to take your flathead screwdriver again, your little micro screwdriver here. We might need to do another strum-strum process. You never know. So, I just want to ensure that when this coil fires, that we're doing it from the interior and that the burn is going that way and this way. You know, so this is just for quality control here, for safety's sake. So let's give it a go. Let's give it a go. I'm actually going to bump this up from 95 watts and I'm going to put it at 110 so that the coil fires quicker. Here we go. I don't think they need real touch, but I'm just going to strum because I noticed this one is heating up a little quicker on the right than it is here on the left. On its left. Give it. You can probably hear what I'm doing right there. Perfect. Now I'm going to turn the mod over, and now we're going to do this one. I'm going to do that one. That one doesn't need touching. That one was perfect. And we are coming in. I don't know if it can be seen. I'll try to engage the trigger again and find somehow, some way for this to be shown. Well, you're going to have to take my word for it. We are at 0.20 ohms. We are sub-ohming here. Now, I let this cool off. Do not touch a heat pinch. As soon as you're done with that process and the strum trum and the heat and the quality control, leave it alone for a minute. Because if you start trying to twist this off as so that you can go for cotton and go for a vape, you might burn your hand. Again, the importance of having another mod during this process. You get your nicotine while you build. So there we go. Just do a little hover. It's cool enough to the touch now. Now I'm going to take it off my mod. Right there. There we go. Put the mod off to the side for a minute. I take my broken ohms meter again. Again, just being used as a handle and a foundation, as previously shown. Nice and tight. And I will take that, making sure that my coils are running this way. Again, you can take organic balls. Not a problem here. A little harder to work with. You're not going to wick up your system any quicker using these, but they can be used. So if you have these in your medicine cabinet and they say American Organic or Japanese Organic or Walgreens Organic or Rite Aid Organic, go for it. If not, if it says hypoallergenic, put the brakes on things, slow your roll, stop everything you're doing, and try to go get yourself some Japanese Organic. So I take a piece of pad, drop it off to the side, take my scissors. And then what I do is I put it to the side and visually say, okay, I'm going to need that much right there. Cut, 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 and a cut there. Now we have a strand of Japanese organic cotton. And then I will hover that above and cut the same size. Right there. Now we got ourselves two matching as close as we can pieces of Japanese organic pad. Always put what isn't being used or what's left over back in the bag for future builds. Can never have enough cotton, can never have enough wire, and God forbid can never have enough juice. But I think we already know that. So again, I'm going to put this perpendicular right here. I take and wet the tip with my tongue, just ever so slightly, my pointer finger, rub, and then whittle one end down best I can to kind of a dull point, like so. And I will put it in there, and this is where the tweezers come into play here, because it's just protruding out. Take your tweezer and ta-da, you grabbed it, pulled it through. Now you take your hand and pull it right on through, right on through. Bingo. Now with my Buddha, I will take the end down to the base, to the bottom right there. I will take that and I use that as a guide. I will cut right there. That was my guide. That's about as much wick as I want with a 26650 RDA. And then I will match this one up as close as I can visually. Bingo. Almost perfect. So now I will take the other, just lick the top of your pointer finger up a little bit, pinch on one end and just start whittling it down to a dull, fine point. There we go. Put it through. I'll turn it around so you can see this. Put it through. Now, see that end right there? That little protruding piece of white right there? That's where these come into play. Grab the end while holding that. And ta-da! Bring it out far enough that your finger can pinch and pull. Do a pinch and pull. And there we go. Now, you don't need to do any type of measurement. Now you just do a visual. You do a visual. I am aligning the end of the scissor with that wick. And now I'll do the same. I'll bring it on. Lining. Bingo. There we go. At least the way I like them and the length I like, two properly cut pieces of wicking material that are properly mounted inside both coil systems. Now with your flathead, take this, bring it on over, stuff it down and around. Right there. Boom. Boom. Just like so. And now twist this one around and do the same thing here. Bring it down and around. A little stuff, stuff, stuff. And a little fluff, fluff, fluff at the end. Bring this one around. Like so. Stuff, stuff, stuff. And a little fluff, fluff, fluff. And ta-da, what do we got there? What do we got there? 20 gauge coils, 10 wraps each, 0.20 ohms, we're sub-ohming, Japanese organic cotton for wicking material, pulled through, properly cut, and stuffed and placed. Little plate, little fluff, little fluff, little fluff. And then underneath the coil, I try to make sure that there's plenty of space between wick, reservoir, and coil for air. You know, the air gets to the coil and you need a little air going around it, and so the vape goes on up into you. Okay. Do the same thing over here. Making sure that the cotton is properly depressed against the reservoir of the RDA. Making sure there's plenty of space between cotton and coil for proper airflow. We have good height. And now the final stage of redundancy, because believe it or not, folks, we're almost done. I will take, again, this in my hand as a handle. Again, I will do one last check of the screws. That one's good. That one's good. That one's good. That one is very good. There. My last layer of redundancy for safety is done. Now, we're done. Today, I am going to use Vape Wild's birthday cake, Matt's VG, with a flavor shot at 6 Nick for vaping during this presentation. So, I am not going to have you wait for me to drabble that upon there, wait for it to properly juice and wick up, and then we're going to be vaping. So, my next stage of this video, we're going to bust out of the vapor's den for a while, and we're going to go into my kitchen with proper lighting, and we're going to see this bad boy in action. So, I will see you in my kitchen. Let's go. Alright, I know at the end of the video, when we got done with the build, I said I was going to rotate out to my kitchen and do the cloud chuck testing out there where the lighting was better. I decided to forego that and plant my ass right back here in my recliner and recess myself deep within the bowels of the vapor's den. I just thought we'd do a little cloud chucking right here. Awesome build. I've let it wick up for about 5 minutes, juiced with the, again, Vape Wild birthday cake flavor, 80 VG, with an extra flavor shot, and six nick. So, you saw the build, step by step, exactly how we did it. We took our time, we did it proper, made sure each coil was built almost an identical clone to the other. Now we're going to see if we get paid. And the paid is the vape. The vape is the paycheck. So let's see if we've earned our paycheck. Let's take a test. If you built with me side by side, and if you got something that needs to be going on and being rocked, let's rock it together. Let's give it a test. Here we go. Oh, look at that. Nice, creamy, buttery, luxurious, thick, awesome vapor. It's like a beast. This is a good little build. Awesome little build. Again, we're holding firm at 0.20 ohms. We're subbing. Not a problem there. We're vaping right at 100 watts. Just awesome. Awesome. Effortless. And that's the way it should be. This is great. Well, I think that pretty much concludes things on my end. Again, sorry about the length of time for the video, but I wanted to take my time to go step by step with you. Not blast, mad dash, rush you to a finish line, and when you get to that finish line, you're standing there pulling your hair out, you got questions that were never answered. Hopefully I took the time to answer some of your questions. You know, I'm not a mad fiend as far as rushing a build. Even when the camera is off, the vapor's den is closed, and I'm out in the common areas of my home doing builds, I'm pretty lengthy. I like to slow things down, take my time, do it right the first time, because doing it right is what it's all about. You know, you can go to other people here on YouTube, such as like Rip Tripper, and at warp speed and the speed of light with high theatrical production value, you know, build some burning RDA that he's setting on fire and going woo about it. You know, or you can go to the likes of a more calm or cool collect, you know, Grim Green. He's got some RDA tutorials too. He'll take you there and he'll slow jam you the news all the way to the finish line. He's a pretty good one to tune into. But for me, what I like to do on my tutorials, again, just take my time. Helps you, helps me. Because you got to get that build right the first time, and I got to get this video right the first time. So if I take my time and you take your time, we're having a good time. Very nice. Almost to the realm to where I might feel comfortable entering this. If it was a little bit more beefier, I might have had to build with a thicker wire. If I could have maybe dumbed it down to maybe 0.1 something, this could be a cloud competition little beast monster. I mean, just beast. Love it. I'll probably enjoy this build for about another 2 weeks. Of course, re-wicking it a couple times every day. But, I think we're done. Again, just take your time. If you're just now busting into the build scene, take your time, be patient. If you need to, rewind certain parts of this video. If you need to go over it again, I don't mind that. Just a wonderful little vape. Wonderful. And again, I don't think I've mentioned this, but to the entry-level person who's busting into the build scene today or recent, make sure that if you're busting into the builds, that you double-check your vape device, like Fuchai 200, you previously saw my IPv4, check up on its owner's literature. Maybe do a Google check if you've lost the literature. Look up the specs. See what it's capable of firing at. The last thing you want to do is rush on out there to copy my video today and buy a 26650 RDA. Go to a brick and mortar, buy your 20 gauge wire. And the last thing you want to do is, you know, fire up YouTube and watch somebody like me having everything I'm presenting today, you know, copying it to the letter and building yourself up an awesome build, but your mod ain't up to the job. I mean, if you got like a Segelli mini volt that only I believe goes up to 45 watts, you are not going to be vaping this at all. This build up here will not fire on some. Just double check your device, make sure it's up to the job, and only build accordingly. If your device can, you know, only fire down to 0.2, build something 0.2 and above, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5. You know, just double check for safety. Be cautious, be careful. And on that note, I'll have a couple exit vapes here. I'll juice this up a little bit. Good little build. This vape, wow, it's hitting like a boss. I've let it steep for about 14 days now. I got impatient. I said I could have given it a couple more, but nah. Ain't gonna do that. So, hope this tutorial was helpful. And in regards to vape health and vape safety, in accordance to builds, you can always check out my Vaporosity playlist here on my YouTube channel. And I got some PSAs and vape cotton and vape safety and vape coil stuff, you know, for safety and health. So you can give those a look. But if you think you got this the first time, my hat goes off to you. And in regards to building, you can build anything. If you got the wire, 26 gauge, 28, 24, 22, 20, 30, 32, whatever it might be, and you got a micro screwdriver kit, and you got some micronized pliers, and you got a mod that's up to the job, and you got a, you know, fairly good RDA that you want to build into, just do it. Again, don't have to copy mine. Just use mine as a reference and build where you want to go. Mmm. Scrumptiously nice. I'll enjoy this all night long here. Juice it up and boom. We're going. But speaking of going, I'll let you go. Again, hope you're having a wonderful time, day or night. Whenever it is you so chose to watch this little video. Well, not little. It did go a little excess, but what do we care? So, take them easy. I might do a build tutorial sometime down the line in the next couple weeks and introduce you to triple post RDA builds. There's a certain select few little challenges when it comes to triple versus what we did today, quad, which I prefer. Some challenges that could come up with triple. And again, just like with this video, I'll do for that video, succinctly take my time, patiently, calmly, walk you through it. So we'll do a triple post RDA build in the next couple weeks. But until then, I'll jump back on the YouTube product review bandwagon. I don't have any real PSAs planned. I don't have any more California vape law videos planned like I've recently done. I think I'm just going to jump aboard the product review bandwagon and carry on. So take them on easy. It's been a pleasure having you and hosting you here deep within the bowels of the vapor's den. And until next time, I'll see you around. Bye-bye.